வெல்கம் வணக்கம் சத்ஸ்ரீகால் அண்ட் ஆதாப். தோஸ் ஹூ டோன்ட் நோ மீ, மை நேம் இஸ் சுனில் ஜுவேரி, ஆல்சோ நோன் எஸ் மிஸ்டர் பாண்ட் இன் த மியூச்சுவல் ஃபண்ட் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி. ஐ ஹவ் பீன் இன் தி ஃபினான்ஸ் லைன் ஃபார் த லாஸ்ட் 31 இயர்ஸ் அண்ட் இன் த மியூச்சுவல் ஃபண்ட் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி ஃபார் ஆல்மோஸ்ட் 21 இயர்ஸ் நவ். ஐ ஹவ் கிரியேட்டட் திஸ் பிளாட்ஃபார்ம் கால் அட்வைசர் டு அட்வைசர், விச் இஸ் த நாலேஜ் அவுட் சோர்சிங் அண்ட் நாலேஜ் என்ஹான்ஸ்மெண்ட் பிளாட்ஃபார்ம் ஃபார் தி IFA கம்யூனிட்டி ஆர் எனிபடி இன் த மியூச்சுவல் ஃபண்ட் பிஸ்னஸ். I welcome you all to this unique and the first of its kind opportunity where I will be mentoring and coaching IFAs across the country through this particular platform, what we call A2A. I have created many quotable quotes and I'm going to be sharing some of these quotable quotes which are relevant in this mutual fund industry and our wealth management practice. We have already completed first year of its operation with a humongous success and peaking at almost 250 subscribers in the first year of its operation. I would request all the viewers who have not yet subscribed to subscribe to the first year of its first year workshops also at the same time, the second year workshop also, which has already been kickstarted with this particular workshop and a video. Get driven by creating wealth for your investors. Corollary to that is wealth creation for your own self. If you get driven by creating wealth for your own self first, it will neither create wealth for your investors or for yourself. So if you get driven by awards and rewards and only selling schemes and products based on that, neither will your investors make money nor will you make money. My endeavor always is investor first, and how do I make my investors rich and happy? If they become our brand ambassadors, then they will take us to the next level of our own advisory practice. If they make money, we will make money. If we make money, I'm sure the asset management companies and the mutual fund companies also will make money. So please keep this in mind that first wealth for your investors, rest will follow. This is important from our advisory perspective also, because many of us get tempted, I'm not saying that all of us do that, but we get tempted to sell schemes and solutions based on awards and rewards attached to that. I have never ever given importance or participated in any of such contests, and I continue to believe in that. Common sense and logic. Everything in wealth management is not only fundamentals and technicals. Add a dash of common sense and logic to it to take it to the next level. Everything is not numbers, everything is not just fundamentals, everything is not just technicals. If we add some kind of a common sense in our wealth creation practice, we will take our advisory practice to the next level and we will create humongous wealth for our investors also. One such example is exit strategy from SIPs. Nobody in the industry had spoken about exit strategy from SIP or even a strategy on profit booking. We have always said invest for long term. At 7,000 Nifty, we said invest for long term. At 8,000, we said invest for long term. At 9,000, we repeated invest for long term. We have made statements like sip karo mast raho, sip karo bhool jao. But are these really strategies which can create long term wealth for your investors? I don't think so. And I have given a lot of data, and I will give you a lot more data in this second year of operation in advisor to advisor platform also. If you would have had some common sense, added some common sense and some logic to our advisory practice by giving a right timely disinvestment calls even from SIPs, I'm sure our investors would be in a different zone altogether. So add some common sense and add some logic to it. And all of us are aware that investors behave irrationally. They invest when the markets are really going up. That means they invest actually in the red zone, which I have discussed in many of my workshop videos. And they actually disinvest in the green zone, which are the cheap valuation zones. Again, the logic and common sense says that if they would have invested in the green zone rather than the red zone, they would have made more money. And how do you do that? Asset reallocation strategies are ideal tools for that. Add some common sense and logic to your advisory practice. If events can shake your clients' portfolios, then one has not done a good job as financial advisor. Investors' portfolios should be shockproof. Make them all-season solutions. Imagine when Brexit was happening, the call by most experts was that the global markets will collapse. Imagine when the Trump was supposed to come to power, the call by most financial experts was if Trump comes to power, actually comes to power, US markets and global markets will collapse. Imagine post-demonetization, Indian markets were supposed to collapse. If somebody would have changed the portfolio construct or strategies in their investor portfolios based on these events only, you and I would not have done a good job as a financial advisor. All we had to do was create strategies which are all season strategies, either through asset reallocation, through SIPs, through STPs, etc., and waited for these events to pan out. Events can't shake our portfolios, the events can't shake our beliefs, events can't shake our wealth creation strategies. Please create all season solutions, and I will guide you to do that during the second year of calendar of Advisor to Advisor platform. Conviction is prerequisite to consistency in your advice. If you are not convinced, you will change your advice frequently based on events, as I just mentioned to you. Have conviction and be consistent. To have conviction, you have to do your own number crunching, you have to do your own back testing. Convince yourself first before you can convince the others. If you are convinced, you will have consistency in your advice also, which will be translated to investors having more faith and respect and trust in you. So have conviction. If you have conviction, no events can shake you and your portfolio and wealth creation exercise. Conviction will lead you to a consistency in your performance and in your advisory practice. Value adds by advisors and need and solution approach will fight the looming threat of direct and disclosure. Move away from the mindset of distribution. Our regulator has been telling us time and again and have put in place a lot of regulations around this, which is only pushing us to move away from distribution mindset and get into the advisory mode. If you want to get into the advisory mode, naturally you will have to make sure that you understand the needs of the customers and thereafter provide the right solutions. As I have been saying from time to time, we are like doctors, our investors are like our patients. We have to recommend the right medicine to our patients at the right times. We cannot blame the AMCs who are like drug manufacturers and who are giving us a basket to select from. So stop blaming the manufacturers for your own inadequate knowledge, because finally you are the doctors, and if the doctors don't know what the patients need and they cannot prescribe the right medicine, the patients will not stay with the doctors. So please understand that value adds and need and solution approach will take you a long, long way in your financial advisory practice. And finally, advisor without knowledge is like a doctor without a stethoscope. Empower yourselves with knowledge. Please join Advisor to Advisor platform, which is an entirely new concept in the mutual fund industry. It will empower you with knowledge. It will empower you in how to deal with your customers. It will give you soft skills. It will give you hard skills. It will help you understand and learn how do you do number crunching, back testing, etc. This will take your advisory practice to a different level altogether. I'm sure you would have enjoyed some of these quotable quotes and found its relevance in your wealth management practice. If you wish to be part of this knowledge enhancement and the knowledge outsourcing platform, please join www.mrbond.in and become a part of the A2A family. The first year we have covered topics like effective investor communication, concepts of debt market, investor behavior and bias, and finally how to get mindshare and wallet share of the investors in the mutual fund business so that you can increase your AUMs and your business also. You can be part of that first year workshop and simultaneously become part of the second year workshop also, which will cover many topics and take you to an enhanced level of in your advisory practice. The second year will cover topics like the market signals, how do you understand asset allocation, why and how of asset allocation, solutions for senior citizens, why should you move away from dividend payouts and get into an SWP mode? What are the quantitative analysis of equity markets just besides the qualitative side also? And many more such topics will be covered in the second year of A2A. I wish to welcome you all very soon on the other side of this video. Thank you so much.